To the working world by IBM. Previously, it was only used for research. Nggak butuh komputer. Kita yang bawa. Now, what is IBM now? We are a company that is very focused on the cloud, that is doing massive transformation, but we haven't forgotten our roots. We started in hardware, we started in infrastructure, and we will continue to bring infrastructure that matters to the current business world, with your help. One century ago, we invented virtualization, if you recall. So a lot of the technologies you see right now were invented by IBM. We want to make your world work better, which is a lofty goal, which means we are transforming into something much better as well, with your help as well. Dan yang pasti, kalau kita ngomong IBM, kita bicara bagaimana caranya permasalahan yang ada di market. Kita sama-sama address. Kita sama-sama cari cara supaya kita bisa address bersama. Together, issues can get solved. Ini yang menarik dari IBM. Teknologinya. Kita punya artificial intelligence paling advanced di dunia. No kidding. Number one. General artificial intelligence paling advanced di dunia. We're talking about Watson, of course. Running-nya di atas apa? Apa yang namanya power systems. We're talking about systems with high reliability, high performance, high flexibility. Semua itu ada di kita, dan itu yang mempower sebuah sistem yang punya artificial intelligence bisa mendekati manusia. And a lot of other technologies as well. Dari yang gak kepikiran, kayak the weather company. We have bought the weather company, for example. Lucu, ngapain kita beli cuaca ya? Kita beli perusahaan yang istilahnya cuma melihat data cuaca. Buat apa? Atau hubungannya sama kita? Kita jualan apa dari sana? The thing is, we have the data. That is why. Sekarang ini jadi interesting buat lainnya. Kenapa saya bilang interesting? Sekarang ini eksekutif-eksekutif seluruh dunia, I'm not just talking about IT companies, but also the non-IT companies, are on edge. Mereka lagi mikir, ini apa yang terjadi nih dengan bisnis saya? Apa nih yang terjadi dengan apa yang saya pegang, what I hold dear? Sebelumnya, kenapa semuanya berubah? Berubahnya bagaimana? Di Uber Syndrome, sebuah kompetitor yang nggak tahu apa-apa soal bisnisnya yang saya jalani ini, misalnya saya apalah, taxi company, gimana? Ini kok saya bisa dimasukin orang yang bahkan nggak punya mobil, cuma punya aplikasi, tiba-tiba aja bisa ngalahin saya. Kenapa nih bisa seperti ini? Dan ini, competition itu akhirnya jadi ambigu. Sebelumnya, mungkin IBM lawannya itu jelas. Mungkin yang lain-lain juga lawannya itu jelas. Sekarang, banyak sekali nih yang bermunculan. Startup-startup yang sangat fleksibel tiba-tiba masuk, namanya nggak ketahuan dari mana, namanya keren banget gitu, aneh-aneh gitu, tapi sebenarnya bukan seseorang yang harusnya kita lawan, tapi melawan kita. All the small companies are coming. Kita nyebutnya lucu, kita nyebutnya digital invaders. They started in digital, they are invading our space. Dan mereka menggunakannya dengan disruptive technologies, teknologi yang bisa mendisrupsi pasar. Ini yang menarik dari dunia kita sekarang. World's largest taxi company nggak punya vehicle. Aneh. Ini juga aneh. Accommodation company, Airbnb, owns new real estate. Ini lebih aneh lagi. Alibaba, world's largest retailer, nggak ada inventory. Okay. Media company terbesar di dunia itu Facebook. Jumlah media yang keluar dari Facebook itu lebih banyak daripada media company lainnya. Dan dia nggak punya konten sendiri. Kalau buat IT bagaimana? IT sekarang mengalami apa yang namanya industry convergence. Not just IT, but the whole industries. Termasuk sekali IT. Kita bisa dapat sekali kompetitor-kompetitor lain yang punya business model yang berbeda dari kita. Different business models. That's the issue. People are coming in and saying, why are you buying a server just hosted on my cloud? I actually have a cloud. You can actually host it on me. You can actually put your software as a service only. That is industry convergence. All the new players, orang-orang yang baru, yang biasanya nggak masuk di situ, akhirnya masuk juga. Okay. kita bicara soal masa depan kita aja. Sebelum masa depan, ini one fun fact, I love this fact. I don't know if anyone knows this, tapi lebih banyak orang yang gak punya sikat gigi daripada yang gak punya HP. Oke, sekarang ngaku aja ya siapa yang gak punya sikat gigi di sini. But that's true. Okay, more people actually have mobile phones than actually brushing their teeth with this. Incredible, right? Now this is a change in all of the technologies. It started with that. From mobile, it goes to social media, it goes to analytics, it goes to all of those things. Orang-orang jadi percaya yang namanya IT itu harusnya bisa secepat Facebook. Jadi saya bisa nanya gitu istilahnya, kalau saya di sebuah perusahaan ini, gue user nih, kenapa gue mau deploy sebuah VM atau mau deploy server baru, gue butuh lama, gue butuh nanya-nanya ke sini, dan butuh beli dari mana-mana segala macam, butuh tender. Sedangkan kalau saya buka Google Groups atau buka Google Docs, langsung nyala satu instance baru. Gimana sih? Lucu. Transformasinya di situ jadinya. Dan itu sebabnya yang terjadi adalah, this is a very, very important slide, the IT department is disappearing. Orang udah gak fokus lagi di IT. The thing is, IT is not their primary concern. I'm a bank, misalnya. I'm a bank, I don't focus in IT. I focus on the finance lah. I'm an FMB. I am an FMCG, misalnya. I focus on the products that I'm selling, not the IT. IT is supporting. So what they do is they outsource. Mereka taruh nih IT departmentnya. Hey, I want someone to take care of my IT. And 40% of all servers by 2020 will be in service provider data center. Okay. Software are being developed for the cloud. This is why, if you're not there, you're missing out on this. This is only for $100 billion. On all of this, in 2014, kenaikannya 24% year to year. It's insane. And we can go there, actually. Kenapa saya bilang begitu? Because we are very strong here. And we are also very strong here. We can be very strong here. IBM sendiri punya latar belakang yang luar biasa, the systems of record, the infrastructure layer, the strength of this. We already have that. And we have new models, basically, untuk support analytics Anda. Social yang belakangnya juga, analytics juga, big data, all of the new trends in the market we can support. Saya lebih suka. Somehow it died. This is why you need a DRC. DRC also died. No. Akan ada lag-nya dulu kan. So, I like creating the future, not just talking about it. And which is why we are actually bringing you all in this room. We are trying to create an ecosystem for you to be an MSP, to be easily transforming into an MSP, giving all of those things, just like those digital invaders can do. That's why we wanted you to come. MSPs can be any type. Ada yang bilang MSP, oh berarti gue harus punya data center. Bukan. Bisa juga ditaruh on-premise. We're just talking about the business model, like put on the best premise, taruh aja di sana, nanti orang saya yang akan maintain. Saya alokasikan orang di sana. That's just a business model. That can happen. That can be calculated as an MSP by IBM and Avnet. Kita bisa hosting kita sendiri, punya barang. Bisa kita gabung dengan yang luar. Bisa kita gabung dengan yang public. Of course, ada data residency, dan kita biasanya harus fokus ke hoster untuk data residency. Okay, but the thing is, there's a lot of flexibility. That's one. Second thing, kita punya banyak sekali di sekitar kita yang potensi. Kita mau misalnya fokus benar-benar only on, hey, you want the cloud? I give you the cloud. Kita bisa masukkan. Kita mau leverage sesuatu yang lebih high value, misalnya analytics-nya. Kita bisa masukkan. Kita mau masukkan ke yang arah mobile, mobile management, manage dari jauh, segala macam. Kita juga bisa lakukan. Semuanya sebenarnya ada. It's just a matter of selecting the content. And these people actually manage to transform. Okay. Jadi ini orang-orang ini dari Visensa. Itu company yang basically they didn't start seperti ini. They didn't utilize IBM technologies to do this. But they did. They transformed their data center pakai power systems, storage kita, cloud orchestrator kita, dan di hybrid dengan apa yang namanya soft layer, infrastructure as a service-nya IBM, public cloud, digabungkan jadi satu. This is something they did in a few short years. Kita bicara juga mengenai orang-orang yang industrinya nggak ada hubungannya sama MSP. Talking about telcos, ini si Vietnam ini, dia punya telco, telco yang besar di Vietnam. The thing is, when they actually offer the connectivity deals, they can also offer the computing deals at the same time, expanding the business also. It's a package. So it's also very successful using IBM. Today, we will talk about enterprise cloud systems, power systems for MSPs. Kita bakal lihat satu offer khusus dari Avnet, hanya sampai akhir tahun ini, just for this quarter. Untuk mereka yang menjadi MSP, investasinya berapa? Dan investasi itu adalah investasi yang luar biasa, very high value, very low cost. Kita akan bicara mengenai Spectrum Storage line of products. Kita akan bicara mengenai CloverSafe. Ini adalah storage-storage yang namanya walaupun ada aneh, tapi ini adalah storage-storage yang bisa utilize your current infrastructure dibuat jadi storage yang lebih mantap. Kita akan menggabungkan semuanya di dalam sebuah cloud yang Anda bisa lakukan. Ini sekilasnya, sekilas infonya. Join di MSP Revolution. Ini saya potong karena bawahnya ada harga. Harganya bukan saya ngomong. So you guys are going to see the pricing later. But this cannot scroll down. So you need to wait until I show the price. Not me, someone else maybe. So let IBM, Avnet, and our partners surround you with value, basically. That is what we can do. Tech Mahindra, for example, adalah partner Avnet juga. Part of this partnership as well. You can talk to them, especially about all of the weird stuff, misalnya financial models, misalnya all of the business model stuff. Mereka bisa bantu nggak? Kayaknya bisa. Because in this region, mereka itu udah close salah satu deal MSP paling besar di dunia untuk IBM, misalnya di Australia. They have that organizational knowledge. Kita bicara mengenai, if you're an ISV, you have something to offer. You have a software, you have a capability yang orang lain nggak punya. You want to offer it as a service, gimana caranya? Talk to them. Talk to the other people in this room, talk to the cloud providers as well. You are a cloud provider. Udah punya cloud. Why should you move to our cloud? Talk to the team. The IBM team, the Avnet team. Lihat betapa produknya bisa sangat lebih reliable, lebih performance, lebih tinggi performance-nya. And that is how you win. Now that is why it's a revolution. So, that's all I have. Actually, you can see this presentation at mbakpandu.com/MSPday. It's actually, okay, so my name is Pandu. The name is kind of male, so I use mbak, so it's like mbakpandu.com. MSP/MSPday. You can download the presentations from today here. Pictures, okay. And again, IBM is doing this revolution for you. It's not for IBM, it's for the future of you. Thank you.